I'm going to get up here and nerd out about music theory and drums pretty much. And the one place that music theory and drums really intersect is drum tuning. Dance music is driven by drums. There's kind of no denying that. They're often the loudest thing in our mix, whatever kind of electronic music you're working in, especially the kick drum. And tuning them correctly is one of the things that kind of contributes towards making a mix sound professional compared to a mix that does sound, you know, bedroom, kind of bedroom producer. That's not to say you can't do professional methods in your bedroom, and that's kind of what I'm trying to show you. I'm going to show you four different methods today for tuning your drums. By the end, I'll show you what they sound like tuned versus untuned, so you can see what a difference it makes in a mix. So first question really I wanted to answer is, which drums are worth tuning? Because some drums are more important to tune than others. So I've got a few drums just set up on this track, and just going through them, the basic rule is the more tonal a drum is, that's the more it represents like a musical note, more it sounds like a note, the more essential it is to tune it. Kind of obvious, I know, but a snare drum, for example, is essential to tune. If you hear that part of the snare from the 808, that's the snare without the white noise. And that always exists there. Here's the snare with the white noise. And that sounds hard to tune, but underneath that white noise sound is this. And that corresponds to a note. Like if I move that around, you'll hear it's changing. Okay? So underneath every snare is some kind of note. Beyond that, kick drums, super important to tune. They're like usually the loudest drum in your mix, depending what genre you're working in. Super loud, and they definitely correspond to a note. That one obviously does. If I tune it up, you can hear it even more. Beyond that, tom drums. Toms are pretty important. Clavs, things like that also obviously correspond to a note. Things that don't correspond to a note so well, we're talking like claps. Claps are pretty hard to tune, but they are tunable. Hi-hats, cymbals, and of course open hi-hats. Before I get to methods, there's one more thing I wanted to tackle, which is what notes should you look at tuning to? Now, if you're using a synthesized kick, it's pretty easy. Using a synthesized kick, you can just choose a note on the piano that corresponds to your song, okay? So you can play the root note on the piano for your kick drum, and that's going to be in tune because you're synthesizing it. If you're working in a sample, though, you've got to repitch that sample. Now, the notes you might want to tune to, if I come over here, I've just set up a blank track with the notes in A minor. And the one I'm hovering over now is the A note. That's the root note. Now, generally speaking, you want to try and tune your kick drum to the root note wherever possible. Your snare drum is the second most important drum in your mix, usually the second loudest, and it happens all the time. You generally want to aim to have your snare tuned to either the fifth or the root note. The fifth is the fifth note you can see there, like one, two, three, four, five. It's seven semitones above the root note. Your other drums, toms, clavs, things like that, you can kind of tune them to any note that's in that scale. Now, that's all good and well, but the million-dollar question in drum tuning is really, what note does my sample actually correspond to right now? And therefore, how many semitones up or down do I need to pitch it or transpose it for it to be at my root note or something like that, wherever you're actually aiming for it to get to? So here's where my four methods come in. Method one, the one I mentioned earlier, by ear, okay? But I have got a couple of tips on this. So doing it by ear takes a lot of practice. It took me, I'd say 1 or 2 years from when I started trying to tune by ear to feel confident that I was actually getting results that were working out well. To do it by ear, you first of all want to solo your drum. So you can solo your drum down here in the drum rack. You want to get your gain structure right and play back that kick against the music. Now, when I say get the gain structure right, I mean get the kick nice and loud versus the music so you can clearly hear what note it's corresponding to. It's pretty hard to hear the note when you're changing it when it's that low. I'll show you. It's pretty hard to hear that. So my one major tip with tuning by ear is to actually pitch the drum up by at least an octave being 12 semitones. If you pitch it up by 12 semitones, it's a lot easier to hear the note that it corresponds to. So listening to that, to me that sounds out of tune. Sounds out of tune, still I go up. That sounds fairly in tune to my ears. It's a little bit flat still. So I can actually fine tune it using detune here. The detune, there's 100 cents to one semitone. Now if I bring that up a touch, that sounds pretty in tune. So that detune parameter there allows you to tune in between semitones, in between notes. As I said, doing it by ear is pretty hard. In my experience, as I said, that takes a couple of years to master, and being a music theory teacher, I have noticed in students it takes a fair while as well. It's not an immediate skill. So method two, this is something you can do straight off the bat. It's more of a technical approach to it. I'm going to reset this kick drum so I can retune it using this method as well. My second method is to use a spectrum analyzer, a frequency analyzer. In Ableton Live, under Audio Effects, you've got one included. It's called Spectrum. If you drop that in after your drum kit and flick this little triangle, makes it nice and big, and then solo a drum through it, it shows you the frequency spectrum of that drum. Now, what you're looking for here on this spectrum is the lowest and loudest peak in the frequencies. That will be the fundamental frequency of the drum. So looking here, I can already see this is actually this line that's staying there is an average of what's been inputted to the spectrum so far, which is only the kick drum. And I can already see there's a bit of a peak here. If I play the kick drum again, you can clearly see there's a peak there where I'm drifting. Now, when you drift over spectrum like this, it actually shows you in the bottom left corner down here which note you're actually corresponding to on a keyboard. So see the letter there, B, at the moment. If I drift back to where that peak is, you can see it's actually corresponding to a G sharp. Now, back over here, a G sharp. G sharp is that note there. And I want to get this kick drum onto my root note. So to go from G sharp there to the A note, which is my root note, is one semitone up. So from looking at that frequency spectrum over here, being G sharp, I can tell I've got to move it one semitone up. And when I've moved that one semitone up, if I now look at it again, you can see it's now corresponding to an A, which is the root note of our song. All right, so I'm going to tune a couple more drums using this method quickly. I'll do the snare as well. Let's do the snare. I'll just solo that snare and the spectrum blowing up. I'll just hit play on that. Oh, there it is. Cool. So that snare there, you can see, has a peak that's louder and lower than any other peak in the frequency. Right about there. And on the readout in the bottom left corner of spectrum, that's corresponding to a D sharp. Now, I was saying earlier that you either want to tune your snare probably to the root note or the fifth. So back over here, here's our root note. And our fifth is the fifth note of the scale. One, two, three, four, five. So I'm aiming for either an A or an E. So considering it currently corresponds to a D sharp, which is this note here, I can get to my fifth by just tuning one semitone up, okay? And then that snare is going to be on the fifth. So back over here on the snare, tune that snare one semitone up. And that should be fairly in tune. Sounds a tiny bit flat, like in between notes. I'm just going to tune it up a little bit with the detune. All right, so I'll do this once, twice more maybe. Actually, I'll do it with the conga quickly. So the conga, if I solo that one. Very clear fundamental frequency here. And that's corresponding to a C sharp, you can see there. I'm going to put it on the root note. And from a C sharp, to get back to that root note, here's a C sharp here. I want to get to the A, that's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 semitones down. So I'm going to tune that conga 4 semitones down, negative 4. And if we listen to that with the mix now, you can hear that's kind of really nicely in tune with the mix now. With the snare and the kick, they're all sounding pretty in tune. Cool, so I tuned a few drums using the spectrum analyzer. I'm going to move on to my next method for tuning drums. It's basically to use one of Live's convert to MIDI functions. So if I open up actually I've got a track ready here, just a plain audio track, and I'm going to go to the current project because in the back end of that are all my samples. And I'm going to drag in the mid-tom, drag that over to here, and I'm going to drag in the kick as well. So if I right-click on one of those and convert melody to new MIDI track, takes a moment to think about it. And over here, it's tried to convert that into a melody being one note, and it's picked a note. And that note it's chosen is the note that it actually corresponds to. So my mid-tom is currently tuned to a C sharp. So this tom being tuned to a C sharp, as it says here, I might retune that to down to a C, which is an A minor still. So I'll take that tom, the mid-tom, tune it down one semitone, which takes it to a C note. And that means my whole kit is now actually tuned. So having listened to that, I'll just get the spectrum out of the way. Having listened to that tuned kit, you can hear that sounds pretty nice with the music. I've got the original, I'm just going to get that out of the way. I've got the original kit over here. This is before I tuned it. And I'm just going to set up a quick key mapping to switch between them really easily with the F key. It's just an A-B test. I'm just going to switch between them. So here's the tune kit. And now untuned. So I hope you could see me switching between them there. It's a pretty obvious difference. When it's tuned, it kind of all sounds like it's in the same spot, same place, and all like harmonious and complementing each other. Now, there's one more tip I've got as far as doing this that can help. It involves a third-party application called MixedInKey. MixedInKey is a program that's designed for detecting the key of your tracks for DJing so you can do harmonic mixing. But I recently discovered it actually also has about an 80% strike rate on tuning kick drums and toms. If you drop your drums in there, the cool thing about putting them in MixedInKey, in your MixedInKey preferences, you can rename the files once they've been detected with the original file name plus the key in the file name. So it means your whole drum library or the 80% strike rate that it's successful for actually can be labeled with the key it currently corresponds to. And it means you can more easily select samples that are going to be in tune with the song you're working on. Or if you've found the sample you're using is not really working out, you can easily select another sample that is working out. Thanks, guys.